The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 23rd, 1973, in London, England.
Today's subject matter is, what is religion? So, we are reciting some verses from the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, where the subject matter, dharma, is discussed. It is said that dharmant sakshat bhagavatam. Dharma, it is Sanskrit word, and the English translation generally it is made as religion. Religion is accepted as a kind of faith. But faith may be wrong or right according to the different time, persons, climate, condition, so many considerations. But Srimad Bhagavat says, dharmantu sakshat bhagavatani. Dharma or religion means the law given by God. Simple formula. As there are laws given by the state, similarly, the supreme state, supreme governor, is the supreme personality of God. God means the supreme being, supreme person. So, are the supreme authority. Supreme means the greatest authority. As in a state, the greatest authority is the government. Similarly, throughout the cosmic manifestation, throughout the whole creation, there must be some supreme authority. So that supreme authority is God, and whatever He gives the rules and regulations, that is called religion. You cannot change it. That is law, whimsically, you cannot change. Then you will be punishable. Similarly, the laws are the words of the regulatory principles given by God. That is religion, and if you do not follow it, then you will be punished. Actually, the Sanskrit word dharma means the constitutional position. We may try to understand what is the meaning of dharma. Just like fire. Fire means there must be heat and light. Without heat and light, there is no meaning of fire. If you say that we have got fire, but there is no heat and no light, so what kind of fire it is? So, that fire and light of, heat and light of fire is to be understood as dharma. You cannot change it. This is no possibility. Otherwise, there will be no meaning. As water, water is liquid. Any water, any parts of the world, when you take water, it is liquid. Therefore, this liquidity is the dharma of water. You take anything. Actually, dharma means characteristic. Anything you take, Just like I am speaking before this microphone. So, it does not produce the sound, then what kind of microphone is it? The sound production from the microphone is the dharma, is the religion. Natural characteristic. So what is the natural characteristic of human being? The natural characteristic is that we serve the superior. That is natural characteristic. Either you become Christian or Hindu or Muslim or Buddhist, nobody can say that I do not serve any superior. Nobody can say. One must serve. That is all. Faith, ritualistic. I am today Hindu. I can accept the ritualistic process tomorrow of the Christian faith, or a Christian may take another ritual. But his business to serve the superior, that does not change. Either you become Christian or Muslim or Hindu, it does not. It is not that Hindus, they only serve in the office, the Christians do not. No. The service is there. So actually the service is in dharma. Not this rubber stamp, Hindu, Muslim, Christian. No. That is designate. Actual dharma means the characteristic. If you taste sugar, it is sweet. The sweetness is the characteristic of sugar. That is dharma. If you take chili, it is very hot. If you take a chili and if it is sweet, immediately, this is not good chili. Because there is no dharma. So, dharma means characteristic. So here in the Srimad Bhagavatam it is said that Vedapanihito dharma jadanmastad viparjaya Vedo Narayana Shakshat Sayambhu Riti Sushuma. Therefore, we have to understand dharma from scriptures. Veda means the book of knowledge. Veda means knowledge. Vitti Veda Veda Gyan. So, you have to take knowledge from authorized scriptures, authorized law book. A big lawyer means who is quite aware of the laws of the state. Similarly, a religious person means who knows completely, at least, or partially also, the laws of God. That is dharma. That is dharma. So, what is God? You have to understand. Then what does He say? You have to understand. Then you can execute actually what is religion. If you do not know what is government, what is the laws of the government, how you can become a good citizen? That is not possible. A good citizen, by good citizen means who abides by the laws of the state. Similarly, a religious person means who abides by the order of God. This is dharma. So, this question was raised by the servants of Jamaraj in the matter of Ajamil Upakhyan. And the Jamaraj, who is known as Dharmaraj, master of understanding the religious principle, so he explained what is dharma. He said, dharmantu sakshad bhagavat pranitam. Dharmantu sakshad bhagavat panitam. Namai vidu ri sayonapi deva. न सिद्ध मुख्या असुरा मनुष्या कुतून विद्या धरचारणादय। देर आर डिफरेंट प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम एंड इन ईच एंड एवरी प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लिविंग बींग्स और ह्यूमन बींग्स। एज वी हैव गॉट ऑन दिस प्लैनेट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस ग्लोब वी हैव गॉट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पर्सन। वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ पर्सन्स ओनली इन ह्यूमन बींग। अदर लिविंग एंटिटीज we are not taking into consideration, because the dharma is meant for the human being, not for the cats and dogs. Religious system is there in the human society. Any civilized human society, there is a system of religion. It doesn't matter what is that religion. That is civilized human civilization. Dharma na hina pasubhi samana. In the human society, in the civilized human society, if there is no conception of God, if there is no conception of God's order or God's law, that is not human society. That is animal society. The cats and dogs or other animals, big animals, they have no sense. What is the law of God? What is God? How to execute that? That is not expected there. Take for example, in your country, the law is keep to the left while you drive your car. That is the order of the state. But if you do not obey the state order, instead of driving on the left side, if you drive on the right side, you immediately become a criminal, punishable. But the same right and left consideration, if a dog and a cat or a cow violates, instead of going on the left side, if he passes, he has no fault. He is animal. Or a child, if he violates law, if I take anything without your permission, that is called stealing. If I enter your house without your permission, that is trespassing. So these are laws, and it is applicable to the grown-up man, intelligent man, civilized man. It must be. If you want to enter somebody's house, and if you see the sign of no admission without permission, you will never go, because you are civilized. But a cat and dog will enter. A child will enter. Therefore, these laws and dharma or religious system is meant for the civilized human being, not for the uncivilized cats and dogs. No. Therefore, when a civilized man, so-called civilized man, has no knowledge of God, no knowledge of the laws of God, it is simply animal society. Yes. Dharme na hina pasubhi samaha. They are animals. They are not to be considered as human beings. This is law. This is religion. You cannot violate the laws of God. You cannot disobey the laws of God. You cannot say that I do not know the laws of God. You must know. Just like a good citizen, you must know what is the law of the state. If you say in the court, "My Lord, I did not know this law," that is not excuse. You will not be excused. As a citizen, good citizen, you are respected. Similarly, we must know what is dharma, what is God, that is human. So, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "Jada jada hi dharma sabglani bhavati bharata, tadatmanam srijamaham." Krishna says, God says, that when there is too much disobedience in the matter of law of the Supreme Lord, adharma, adharmasya bhuktana, godlessness, without any knowledge of God, without any knowledge of the God's order, that is called dharmasya glani, discrepancies in the matter of discharging the order of God. Tadātmānam śrījāmaham, at that time God advances or descends. He descends personally, he descends by his representative, by his son, or by his name also, because they are all identical. God, his representative, his name, his form, his activities, everything in relation to God, that is also God. This evening we are discussing. Actually, this world is also God. Idam nivisham, Bhagavan iveta. Visham is the whole universal creation. Because it is creation of God, God has created. Therefore, the whole universe, the whole creation is also God. Although it appears different from God. For example, just like the sun and the sunlight or sunshine, although apparently different, sun is different from the sunshine, still sunshine is also sun. Without sun, how there can be light in the sunshine? So, in broader sense, there is nothing but God, everything God. This is explained in the Vishnu Purana. Ekadesasthita agni jyosna vistarina jatha. Sarvaiva brahmana shakti. Tathedam brahmana shakti. As the fire is placed, is situated in one place, but it is distributing the heat and light. Similarly, the Supreme Lord, although he is in his abode, the Goloka Vrindavan, is still, by his energy, he is all pervading. All pervading, everywhere there is God. The sun shines. The sun is 90 million miles away from us. But as soon as the sun sign is there, we can understand there is sun. So if we are thoughtful, then we can understand what is God and how his energies are acting. That we can understand. Exactly like that. As the fire is situated in one place, but the heat and light is working. Similarly, you can understand the existence of God by the energy of God. The energy, how the energy of God is working. You can understand God. And the energies are acting under certain laws given by God. That is the sunshine. There is a particular time, at this hour, the sun sign will be visible. At night, if you want sun sign, it is not possible. However advanced you may be in science, however scientific machinery you have discovered, but you cannot get sun sign in this night, dark night. No scientist can say, now we have discovered a scientific method by which at night also sun will rise. No, that is not. Of course, they sometimes say like that, rascal-like, but that is not possible. You cannot change the law of God. That is not possible. If you want sunshine, then you have to wait till morning. When by the grace of God, by the order of God, sun will rise, you will get sunshine, not by your scientific method. Similarly, here it is stated, dharmantu sakshat bhagavat pranita navai vidu rishayanapi deva. Rishaya, rishaya means great sages. Rishaya, great sages, great saintly person, or great thoughtful philosopher, even scientist. They cannot create dharma. Dharmantu sakshat, sakshat, direct. Dharma is directly made by God. Not that because one is very great saintly person, great philosopher, great scientist, he can make a kind of religious system. No, that is not possible. That will not be religion. That may be something else, but that is not religion. Religion must be given by God. Dharmanta Sāsāl. He denied here in this verse, Navai vidu rishayanapi deva. Vidu, vidu means knowing. Rishaya, great saintly person. Navai vidu rishaya. Napi deva. Deva means demigod. There are very, very big, powerful demigods. Just like Indra, Chandra. The sun is also demigod. The sun is distributing the light, that is by the order of God, not independently. Anything you find, they are abiding by the laws of God, by the giving the light, that is by the order of God, not independently. Anything you find, they are abiding by the laws. Many shastras, we have to take knowledge from the shastras. And if you judge from good sense and intelligence, you will have to admit what is said in this shastra. Now just like in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said that maya dhakshena prakriti suyate sa characharam. We are very much astonished to see the activities of the material nature. Wonderfully working. But we do not know that behind the material nature there is God. Under His direction the material nature is working. That is intelligence. Material nature, matter. Matter cannot act independently. That is not possible. Just like this microphone is a combination of material things. Some iron, some other metals. But it has been adjusted, created by some living entity. Not that matter has automatically come into intermingling with each other and become a microphone. That is not possible. Take any machine. It may be very wonderful machine. Just like nowadays the wonderful machine is computer. So it acts very wonderfully. But there must be an expert man to push the button. Otherwise it will not happen. Without that expert man, this wonderful machine is lump of iron, that's all. It has no value. Take any machine. Similarly, this huge gigantic machine of cosmic manifestation, where innumerable planets are floating in the sky, just like cotton swab. Don't think that it is so acting automatically. No. There is direction behind it, or there is brain behind it. And that brain, that big brain, is God. God is also like us, a being. But He is Supreme Being. As we are being, we have got our brain, we have got our creative power, we can do something, we can manufacture something like aeroplane, Sputnik. But God has got big brain. We may float one mechanic aeroplane in the air, but by the God's brain, millions and trillions of heavy planets are floating in the air. That is God's brain. He has got also brain. He has got also creative power. We have also creative power. But we have got little, and He has got supreme power. That is the difference. God means the supreme brain, the supreme power. And we are teenies. We are subordinate. Therefore, our position is to abide by the orders of God. That is actually religion. That's all.